Belinda presents this unabridged recording of The First 3 Months, a Tresillian guide to caring for your newborn baby, written by Tresillian and read by Raechyl French. About Tresillian. Established in 1918, Tresillian is Australia's largest early parenting organisation, providing family-focused care for thousands of families each year. With services rapidly expanding to reach more metropolitan and regional areas, Tresillian helps parents gain confidence in their roles as mums and dads and provides evidence-based education and support around breastfeeding, infant sleep, settling, and nutrition to maximise each family's well-being. Need advice? Contact the Tresillian Parents Helpline on 1300 272 736 or go online for advice at tresillian.org.au. Acknowledgements. I would like to thank the people who have provided me with support, encouragement, and contributions for this book. Firstly, I want to thank Nikki Brown, Director, Education, Professional Practice and Innovation, for her partnership, support and reassurance. Nikki's contribution was invaluable and essential to producing this book. I am very grateful to Anne DeBellin, Tresillian Clinical Nurse Consultant, Perinatal and Infant Mental Health, for her assistance with reading and providing comments to content and suggesting improvements for each chapter. As always, Anne Patton, Tresillian's Director of Marketing and Communications, was chief cheerleader, reinforcing my efforts, providing honest and helpful feedback, and offering support every step of the way through the production of the book. I would like to thank Robert Mills, CEO of Tresillian, who once again gave me the opportunity to write this second book and made sure that I had the time and space to do it. This was a more challenging book to write than the first, but very rewarding. Also, I want to gratefully acknowledge the Tresillian nursing workforce and the mothers and babies I work with at Tresillian. They provide me with a wealth of experiential knowledge and wisdom. Finally, I thank all the distinguished experts in my field of expertise whose knowledge I have drawn on extensively to write this book. Fran Chavasse. Foreword. I am honoured to write the foreword for The First 3 Months, a comprehensive, yet not overwhelming, guide for new parents. Pregnancy, birth, and becoming a new parent are times of enormous joy and happiness. It's a leap of faith into the great unknown and, as parents who have gone before you, we know that expectations don't always match reality. Too often, however, the pregnancy and parenting journey is presented using language and tone that is essentially negative, even alarmist. The beauty of this book is that it's a gentle guide. Like the Tresillian nurses, this book nurtures the reader, walking alongside them and helping them to find their own pathway. It's interesting to speculate how Tresillian has changed, as have social norms and expectations of pregnancy, birth, and parenting, over its 100-year time span. For mothers, the sense of responsibility to grow a new life, to be a safe vessel, and present an ideal image of motherhood is probably not new. In the era of social media, however, the message is amplified and the pressure to be perfect can be overwhelming for many new mothers. Men have also arrived in the picture for the first time. When Tresillian was founded, this was a space in which men were to be seen and not heard. In fact, they were rarely even seen. Without a book like this one, my experience of my wife's pregnancy, the birth of our children, and early years of their lives was remote and detached. I went to work because that's what fathers did. Happily, the positive role that men can play and experience as a support for their partners and as valued parents in their own right is now firmly entrenched and encouraged. It may also be hard to accept that the value of parenting is also a fairly recent, and constantly evolving phenomenon. Previously, the role of the parent was relatively passive. Children grew up in an environment separate from the world of adults, and the parent-child relationship was often defined by authority. Providing for your children was about ensuring that their physical and economic needs were met. Emotional needs were secondary, and developing a relationship with your child was a passive process, one that hopefully occurred but wasn't actively pursued. The most critical human relationship and the single greatest life-changing event was relegated to being just a part of life and, in my opinion, an opportunity was lost. The message that resonates with me in the first 3 months is that parents are encouraged to find joy and wonder in pregnancy and birth, and to explore the world with their new baby. At a time in human history when we think that everything is known, this part of human experience remains an opportunity for discovery. Tresillian gives parents the permission to laugh and cry, and to feel overwhelmed and scared. Most importantly, this book reminds us that parenting matters for mothers, fathers, and their child. While it acknowledges the difficult parts, it also offers reassurance, support, and understanding. This is a guide, rather than a set of instructions, and the book's content reflects the culture of an organization that has nurtured women and their families in New South Wales for more than 100 years. As a father of 5 children, I recall reading the books of the time, seeking reassurance as the baby refused to sleep, vomited after each meal, had a fever, or couldn't read Tolstoy at the age of 6 months. I would read and read, looking for the answer, the key that would unlock the mysteries of parenting. Dr. Christopher Green, a pediatrician who had been one of my teachers, wrote Toddler Taming. Out of the pages came a message that has stayed with me. You are a good parent. You love your child. This is normal and it will be okay. At 2 o'clock in the morning, with very little sleep, those words were important. For parents in New South Wales, this book, the Tresillian nurses and staff, and the whole wonderful organisation convey this message each and every day. For that, we are grateful. Dr. Vijay Roach, obstetrician and gynaecologist, president of the Royal Australian and New Zealand College of Obstetricians and Gynaecologists. Chapter 1. Preparing for baby. When you finally give birth and get to meet your new baby after 9 months of pregnancy, it is a hugely exciting moment. It can also be a time filled with mixed emotions. The first few days after birth can be awesome, overwhelming, and exhausting for you. You will be spending time gazing and cuddling your baby, but also trying to figure out how to feed him and change his nappies, and your body needs to recover from the birth. If you haven't given birth to your baby, but he has come to you much loved and wanted from an adoption or surrogate pregnancy, you will also experience the same emotional experiences of elation and exhaustion. You will gaze at your baby and wonder at his delights, while you struggle to figure out how to feed him, get him to sleep, and readjust to a total change to your life. If this is your first baby, then there's plenty of planning to do prior to the birth of your baby. The internet has all sorts of checklists that tell you what sort of equipment your baby might need and how you should prepare your home and baby's nursery, and it might seem a bit overwhelming. For ease of discussion, in this audiobook, birth will be used to describe your baby's arrival. All caregivers will be referred to by female pronouns, maternal or mother. In this context, mother refers to any biological or non-biological primary caregiver. The baby will be referred to as male or female in alternating chapters. This chapter discusses preparing for your new baby. We will cover what you'll need for your baby, what you'll need for yourself, a safe sleep space for baby, car seats, prams, baby slings, and other important equipment, preparing for the next stage, labour and birth. What you'll need for your baby. practical items for your baby. First off, you will be bombarded by advertising about all the absolutely indispensable items you'll need to care for your baby. It's tempting to be attracted by the bright and colourful gadgets available, but it's usually best to stick with the basics until you get to know what you really need. If you have friends or relatives with new babies, they will be your best guide. Often, friends and family pass on clothes and other useful items. In the meantime, here's a list of ideas contributed by other mums that might help you. New babies wee, poo, and may bring up quite a lot of milk, so they tend to get messy. So your new baby will need quite a few changes of clothes at first. Opt for clothes that are easy to get on and off, such as jumpsuits and singlets. These clothes need to be easy to wash and dry. You may even benefit from some soft cloths or bibs to catch the milk spills. At birth, he'll probably need size 40 baby clothes, but if you have a very small baby, you may wish to invest in at least one 50, just in case. It's also a good idea to start off with some larger sizes to save money, because your baby will grow quickly. If you have no objection to secondhand clothes, friends or family frequently offer to give or lend newborn clothes because they wear their small sizes for such a short time. If they are clean and not too well worn, this can be a good money-saving idea. If your baby is born in winter, you may want to purchase 2 or 3 cardigans and 2 cotton hats without strings or bows. It's important for your baby to wear a cap in winter to keep his head warm. Because his head is quite large compared to the rest of his body, he loses a lot of heat through his head. Caps are a good way to keep him warm, especially when you're out and about. Your baby will need about 6 to 8 nappies a day. New babies can get very messy. If you are going to try reusable cloth nappies, you will need about 18 to 24, depending on how often you wash them. It's usually best to have a 3-day supply in case of rain. Cloth nappies are best soaked and washed every day to second day. The nappies have waterproof outer layers and soft reusable inserts that are laundered. If you plan to use cloth nappies, you might like to sign up with a cloth nappy washing service for the first month or so while you settle in. There are a number of nappy washing services available in each Australian state and territory, which can easily be found with an online search, nappy washing services. Some nappy services offer their own packages of cloth nappies included with the laundering. Have a supply of some soft muslin wraps. Your baby will need to be wrapped so he feels safe and cozy. A supply of baby wipes for cleaning your baby's skin at nappy changes. He doesn't need baby wipe warmers, special disposable nappy bins, or even special disposable nappy bags. There are plenty of ready-made nappy wipes on sale, or an alternative is a reusable flannel baby wipe system. Importantly, the less plastic we use, the better for the environment. Sometimes, your baby can get a red bottom from pooing and weeing so frequently. It's therefore good to protect his tender skin with a protective nappy rash cream. You will need fitted sheets for the cot and a blanket if you're using one, but your best option is an infant sleeping bag that meets Australian or New Zealand standards and complies with safe sleeping recommendations. A safe infant sleeping bag is made so that the baby cannot slip inside the bag and become completely covered. The sleeping bag should be the correct size for the baby, with a fitted neck, armholes or sleeves, and no hood. You should have a safe place to bath your baby, such as a laundry tub or baby bath, and some soft towels. You may like to use a safe change table with a change mat, or, alternatively, you can change your baby on a mat on the floor, which is safer. If you are thinking of using dummies or bottles, you will need a steriliser such as a microwave steriliser. You will also need a pram and car capsule. One mum recommends a combo if possible, plus a cot or bassinet, baby sling, wrap or pouch, and bouncinet. See individual sections below for more information. What you'll need for yourself. You also need to take care of yourself after you have the baby, physically and emotionally. Here are some more ideas. If you're breastfeeding, you'll need a nursing bra and plenty of breast pads. You probably won't need a breastfeeding pillow or special breastfeeding chair. It might be an idea to wait and see if you need those before spending the money. You will need lots of sanitary pads. Maternity pads are recommended because there is quite a heavy flow in the first days after your baby is born. Once you've had your baby, make sure you stock up on groceries, fresh fruit and vegetables, and easy-to-cook food you like. When you get home with your baby, everything is going to be quite topsy-turvy for a while, so cooking is going to be the last thing on your mind. Eating for sustenance is what's important at this point. However, if you're so inclined and have the energy prior to your baby's birth, you could prepare and freeze some meals for later. Try and have 3 healthy meals a day, using the food you've stocked up with. It's easy to melt cheese on toast in the microwave, or smash the ubiquitous avocado on toast. Have a small snack in between meals. Try to avoid junky processed foods. You know the drill. Make sure you drink plenty of water and have a glass of water each time you breastfeed. If you don't drink enough water, you can feel tired, cranky, and may get headaches. Drinking water is essential. Make sure you can have a shower when your baby is asleep. Even better, have your shower when someone is with you and can look after your baby. When you get to have a shower each day, you'll feel much better. Once you're settled at home, it's important to enjoy social contact and support. Your local mother's group is a good place to start. Try and go for walks in the fresh air with your baby. You will both feel better. It's perfectly normal, almost mandatory, to have a messy house for the first month after your baby is born. It shows you're only interested in your baby, and that's a good thing. If you've had a difficult labour and birth, you'll need to talk with someone about your experiences to get some emotional relief. It's a shock when your labour and birth is different from the lovely natural experience you dreamed of. Sometimes, your partner, family, and friends are helpful, listening, and supportive. This is exactly what you need. Hopefully, you'll get visits.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.